And welcome back to another War Thunder video. I'm not exactly sure how long this one's going to be. I'm not really going to be ranting as in a pissed off kind of rant, but it is something that's a little bit of an annoyance. Collectible or exclusive or unique vehicles, whatever you want to call them, have been around in War Thunder for a long time. These are the vehicles that are available for a limited time or available through special means, not including bundle vehicles, because they're always available to buy in the game with Steam money or through the main website, as long as you're logged in. They're always available. Anything that is limited time is a collectible, an exclusive, a unique kind of thing. I never liked it when Gaijin would use the word unique, because most of the premium tanks are unique in the first place. But whatever. Either way, I've loved collecting vehicles. There's no doubt about that. However, some of my tech trees, including my United States Aviation, still have quite a bit of grinding to do. I mean, I don't even have the P-38L. I also need the F-2H-2, the other F-9F-5, I need the B-57B, I need the F-84B, I need all three Sabres. I still have a lot of grinding ahead of me. And currently, the P-38K is a good grinder. It's good. I still have a lot of practice because it's a P-38, and I don't have much practice with P-38s. But the moment I got the A26C45, after getting some sleep and waking up, I realized that's a Tier 4 premium exclusive, well, attacker as far as I'm concerned. It's called a bomber. In fact, it's literally the only plane in the game that is called a bomber as far as I'm concerned. The rest of them are medium bombers, light bombers, dive bombers. I consider it an attacker because it's kind of like the B-25 in that it gets forward-facing guns and a shitload of bombs. That's just me. In fact, I think this thing can carry more bombs than the B-25. And it's got some guns. It's basically, as we've always said, the A-20G on steroids. Alright? And so I was like, a Tier 4? Awesome ground attack aircraft? Hell yeah, give me some of that. That'll be great for grinding out my tech trees. My United States tech tree, finally. But then, when I logged in and realized, for starters, the aircraft comes completely stock. You don't get any of the upgrades. As most other premium aircraft you buy and bundle vehicles you buy come all unlocked. And most of the exclusives, such as the P-51A that I got, came fully upgraded. And it gets premium bonuses. The A26C45 does not get premium bonuses. Which is odd. I was like, wait, what? If you go to the modifications, you'll notice you have to buy the talisman if you want premium bonuses. It's a golden vehicle that acts exactly like a standard vehicle. Now, this isn't anything new. Sometimes Gaijin have done this before with some of their aircraft. For example, I believe the exclusive, yep, the D-521 was the same way, and they just released another modification for it, the engine injection. It came completely stock, but, yeah, and it came without premium rewards. So you had to buy the talisman on that one as well. But other ones, you know, that are on the standard tech tree, such as the Gladiator Mark IIs, or apparently the Japanese KI-10-2C, or say, for example, the PO-2, they all come standard, no modifications, no premium reward, because they're standard, they're in the standard tech tree. Then why do some of the exclusive vehicles come to the premium tech tree with no modifications and no premium bonuses? It doesn't make any sense to me. The I-103, I always say 103. The I-301 and LAG-323 both came fully upgraded with premium bonuses. Most of them do. Some of them don't. And for example, other ones, such as the, right down here, M-24TL, which was the other exclusive you could have gotten alongside the P-51A, came in the premium tech tree as a blue-colored vehicle with no premium reward and stock, no modifications. It's as if it should be over here because it's blue, and it just doesn't make sense because the P-51A, which was side-by-side for doing the same stuff, why did this one come golden with all of the modifications with premium bonus, while this one was the exact opposite in every single way. Now, this is actually a good thing, in my opinion, for the A26C45. The fact that I have to buy a talisman for it is actually better, in my opinion, than it just automatically getting a reward. The only bad thing is that it's going to cost me more money. Right now it has 78% research points bonus, which isn't that much. It's exactly like having one of these standard vehicles over here. For example, the F7F1 Tiger Cat actually gets more in the way of a research points bonus, 84%. But that's because the battle rating is much higher. Now, I stated in one of my, you know, how I like to grind videos that it's actually more effective to buy a talisman on a standard vehicle for research points bonuses than it is to buy a premium vehicle. For example, a tier 5, take for example, let's just say this vehicle right here. You want to use your F9F5 Panther as a ground attack aircraft. You don't have to use it as a ground attack aircraft. I'm just saying, say you wanted to and you want a research points bonus. I mean, it can equip rockets and shit. You know, but so say that, you know, that and you want to equip a talisman. Well, it gets 100% bonus right off the bat. Go to modifications. Talisman is going to increase that by 200%. That means you're going to be getting a 300% XP or RP bonus off of your tier 5 jet than with the best reward that you can get already off of a premium vehicle, which, as I'm looking through here, looks to be 244% on the P-38K, for which you cannot buy talismans for premium vehicles. So that's already over 50% more RP gain that you're getting on your Tier 5. But see, the thing is I'm not good with jets, and I'm definitely not going to be good at a ground attack one until I get practice. So I'd much rather have a Tier 4 vehicle with bonuses. And see, the thing is I look at all of the Tier 4 United States aircraft, and I like them. I love the F8F1B Bearcat. I like the F7F. I haven't flown the AD2 yet, but I'm sure I'd like that. And the P-51s are fun, but none of them are like the other nations. The other nations in Tier 4, I have vehicles I love to shit. Like, I love the hell out of in both ground forces and aviation. And for Ground Forces United States, there are vehicles here, like the T-32 and whatnot, that I am crazy for, of which I do have a talisman on. And look at that, 292% bonus, as opposed to the premium M26E1, which has 268% bonus. So now my peer grinder is the T-32. But now they raise the battle rating, and you get the point. Back to aviation. And the same goes for the aviation on the other ones. There's usually always a few different vehicles at Tier 4 that I'm in love with. For a long, long time now, ask any people I used to fly with, I just, for some reason, have always been had this really bad relationship with Tier 4 United States. They haven't been getting enough newer vehicles at their Tier 4, besides, like, for example, the P-38J and P-38L, the B-29, 82 was a little while ago, and the F-7F. You know, those are the only real planes that we've gotten so far. However, their premiums, though, I love the P-47M. I love that thing to death, P-38K. But as for their standardized, no, not really. So to have a premium good grinder would be great. Now, the A26C45, if I bought the talisman, this thing would have a... I'm trying to think here. $178. It should have, I believe, about a 256%, I'd assume, RP gain, which is already more, just a little bit more than my P-38K, but I've always been able to make more RP off of ground attacking than anything. Look, it would have the exact same RP gain as a P-47M, which, that's kind of odd how this thing is higher battle rating. That's only... this is for arcade. Let me switch to realistic. What is realistic in this thing? 6.0. It instantly went up. Holy shit, okay. Yeah, but the RP gains stay the exact same. Damn, I didn't realize the A26 was 6.0. I thought it was 5.3 at first, but that was because I was in arcade and didn't realize it. Oh shit. I might be having second thoughts now. Oh well. Either way, it would be more RP that I'd be gaining than anything here because I would just suck with these aircraft. It was just the main point of the video is I don't understand why it came completely stock with no premium bonuses when it's a golden vehicle. When most of the other exclusives come fully upgraded with premium bonuses. And they've never been able. It doesn't seem like they've ever had made up their mind. I don't understand it, okay? It's the same stuff every single time. For example, like I already went through some of the examples, P-51A came fully upgraded with premium bonuses, but the opposite one that you could have gotten during the event comes blue in the premium tech tree, or in the premium tree, with none of its upgrades, and it doesn't get premium bonuses. While, once again, for example, the M8A1, another one that came fully upgraded with premium bonus and whatnot. I don't know. It doesn't make any sense to me. KV-1B was the same way. VK-4501P was the same way in terms of coming fully upgraded with premium bonuses. M4 was the same way. I'm just trying to look through here. Let's go to aviation for these guys. Their HE-51 was the same way. HE-112 was the same way. BF-109 was the same way. The Russians, like I said, these two were the any P-63 or P-39 that were exclusives came that way. The Spitfire came that way. It's for the British. The D-521 did not come that way, but the Boston, the DB-7 did. And as for the Japanese, they don't have any of them in the golden tech tree, as far as I'm concerned. I keep calling it a tech tree in the golden tree. I don't know. Just thought it was odd. Wanted to share my opinions on the matter, but I'm not gonna go and buy a talisman on it just yet, but I am gonna fly it a few times to see how the battle rating works and see if I can actually make any successful matches. If I can make some good matches on average with ground kills, then hell yeah, I'm definitely gonna buy the thing for this. But I'll have to do some research on exactly what kind of battle ratings I'd be fighting. 7.0, which means I'll be seeing very, very early war jets probably. Do the Germans have any 7.0s? Well, this 6.7. I'm just trying to see what would be in my battle rating range. These two things. Oh, good. I could see the M20, the M26, ME262. What about for the Russians? Yeah, I could see those. Could see that. Won't see the MiG-9. Won't see that, so there's nothing too much to worry about them. But yeah, I'll definitely be seeing a lot of early war jets. No meteors, no vampires. Doesn't look like I'd be seeing any of the British. And the Japanese, I could see their ME262 design and either of the R2Y2s. Okay, well, that makes me feel a little bit better, because I was worried I'd be fighting things like LA-15s, MiG-15s, and whatnot, but no. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next War Thunder video. As long as I don't have to be fighting the US with my US plane, I should be fine.